is, there's a reason to pick this up, and you're looking at it right there. That is an extraordinarily gorgeous, one-of-a-kind, beautiful butterfly. Why is that so important to M71749, and why you should pick this incredible array of these butterfly bouquet live plants? Well, guess what? Stephanie's back, and she's going to explain it. First of all, Asclepias? Did I pronounce it right?
Asclepias.
Asclepias. Great. Okay.
There you go.
Now that we see it, now that people are going to shop, 10,000 already ordered. What's the challenge with the monarch butterfly in America?
Great question, Rick. So, you know, I'll just preface this by saying you're watching this garden day. If there's one plant that you're going to pick up all day, all season, let it be this Asclepias, because this is the only home and food for the monarch butterfly. And what I mean by that is that the monarch butterflies will come and they will lay their eggs on these Asclepias leaves, only these leaves. And once those eggs hatch to create those gorgeous caterpillars, these are the leaves that those caterpillars will eat.
Wow.
Only these ones. And so, you know, over the last two decades, Rick, the monarch butterfly population has decreased by 80% in just 20 years.
Has it really?
Yes.
The monarch butterfly population has decreased by 80%. And that has a lot to do with pesticides and a lot of things, right? There's a lot of reasons. No need to do a news story on it. That's not our job here, but it has decreased. So this guy, you take this home, you get him. I'm getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here's what I'm getting.
Correct.
Buy them now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are perennials. They're coming back year after year after year. The flowers are incredibly pretty. Look at this color. Apricot color, the white, they look like these incredible petals. And now once I get them, once I plant them, here come our friends, the monarchs, huh?
Exactly. So truly, you know, whether you have a townhouse, an apartment, an estate, by planting this Asclepias, you are doing your part in helping save the monarch butterfly population, because you are providing a home and a feast for those butterflies and the caterpillars. And, you know, this is also known as milkweed, which you might be familiar with. But traditionally, milkweed, because it is native to North America, it grows like a weed, kind of out in the woods. And it's not the most pretty plant. I mean, the butterflies love it. But so we brought this collection, Rick, which has been hybridized to be beautiful for us, for a feast for our eyes. They're getting three gorgeous colors, this amazing white, which is very special when it comes to Asclepias. And then you're getting that gorgeous orange and the pink. And if we could just hold right here, Rick, because this is the caterpillar. You know, traditionally, you might see bugs or caterpillars or things crawling around on your plants, and you would want to remove them. But if you see these gorgeous little critters, make sure you let them stay on the plants, because they are meant to be there.
I want to get this. This is great. That's great.
It is great. Mm-hmm.
That's really cool. So take a look. You're getting all these. So in this guy, you're not choosing any of these colors. You're going to get all these colors. Is that right, Stephanie?
That is correct. You're getting six pieces, two of each color.
Wow. Get them now. Mm-hmm. Come on in. 10,000 ordered. You're getting six of these. So where am I putting these in? What's the best place to get maximum success? Would it be in a lot of sun? A little bit
Great
of sun?
Great question.
Yeah.
Yes. You know, the more sun, the better. That's going to help provide those gorgeous flowers for us to enjoy. But if I could suggest picking up two collections, you know, plant a couple of collections or one of the collections in a container, maybe by your deck where you're going to be sitting outside to enjoy seeing all the pollinators and the monarch butterflies coming, and then plant another collection kind of far out just for the butterflies to go and enjoy by themselves and have, you know, some more, as my uncle Court likes to say, this is their salad bar. They're going to go and they're going to enjoy and they're going to be eating all summer long.
That's cool. And again, it's called Asclepias?
Asclepias.
Asclepias.
Yes.
Not the easiest one to pronounce, right?
You but can call the it milkweed if you want.
Milkweed is the other way to pronounce it. That's easy for me. When I get them, I always like to ask this. I love the full sun story. These are perennials. Are coming back next year. How long before these guys get to be these guys and the butterflies are attracted? Are they coming in the first season?
Oh, absolutely. And the plants that you have with you, Rick, that's you know, that's one collection. So you have three plants in each container. And that's probably after the second season. But these are super winter hardy. They can take extreme cold temperatures, and they're actually drought tolerant once established. So anybody can grow these with success. And I truly do believe everybody should be growing these, because by planting them, you are doing your part in helping revitalize and regrowing that monarch butterfly population that has dwindled so significantly over the last two decades.
So again, excuse me for asking the educational question, but this is like one of the primary plants that attracts the monarch butterfly specifically.
Correct. So you will get tons of other pollinators to come and enjoy this plant, but I'm not lying when I say this is the only plant that the monarch butterfly will lay its eggs on. And then once those eggs hatch to those caterpillars, the caterpillars will only eat this Asclepias foliage. They won't be going to the, you know, your other butterfly bushes that you're growing or your bee balms. They will only be eating this plant. So you really do, if you want to have more monarch butterflies in our lives, which we all do, you really do need to grow this plant.
This is the final hour of our big home and garden event. We've got a big, big Roomba event coming up at midnight. Stay tuned. Another 1,000 people are on the line. That is a caterpillar. This is $21.79, only here at the Q. Asclepias, or milkweed. It's M71749. Yes. First day presented. 11,000 ordered today. When you get it, plant it. Full sun is your friend. Not a problem whatsoever. And here comes the brand new hotel, the brand new Holiday Inn, the brand new Ritz for your monarch butterfly. So I think you'll enjoy it. I think they're easy to care for. And again, year to year, if they're hardy, not a problem whatsoever. So any states that shouldn't want to plant these?
No, absolutely not. Everybody can grow this, whether you live in Southern California like myself or up, you know, near the Canadian border. They can take all temperatures.
Wow. These are all real plants. No faux here. These are fantastic.
That's
so
right.
If you want to get auto delivery, I think it's, again, this time next year, if you want to do it. One future shipment in spring of 2022, a total of two shipments. It's an opportunity. You can cancel at any time, but go for it. They're beautiful. How tall will they get, Steph?
Because these are a hybridized version, these are bred to actually be beautiful for us. They're only going to get about 3 feet tall, whereas traditional native milkweed, those grow like 6 or 7 feet tall. So leave those to the fields and to the woods for the butterflies to enjoy.
Just like the hydrangeas, just like the roses and the hydrangeas.
Exactly.
They don't get out of control. Way to go. Way to go, Roberta's. All right. I got a reminder. Speaking of the roses, they.